Hi guys, thank you for joining me. This morning at 5:34 Pacific Standard Time AM, there was a magnitude 3.9 earthquake near Bodfish, California. 284 people so far reportedly felt this earthquake. It was shallow, 6 kilometers in depth. That would be about 3.7 miles in depth. I have two different monitors here. The one on the left is the closest, and the one on the right is farther away. Glamis, California. Let me bring it out, and I'll go to the location. You can see how far it is from where it occurred. Yeah, that's the location. They've recently reported a magnitude 1.8. The other monitor is from Arvin, California. Yeah, way over here. That's another one that's quite a ways from where the earthquake occurred, but it was the two closest ones that I could find. Here's the seismic wave for Arvin, and this is for the other one. You can see it's got a long P wave. This other earthquake signature is from Smith Valley. Shows you how far that was. That was in Nevada. I reported that one earlier. And like I said, this one also shook up the Yellowstone caldera. There's been some smaller ones. 1330, a long seismic wave there. Some more there. Yeah, it's just really acting up, and this is what it's showing now. We've got another one here. This here is the signature of the 1.8. Let's look at the spectrogram. Yeah, I really need to find some monitors that are a little bit closer. This looks like a tectonic earthquake, where we have the plates of the earth moving. Here's the 1.8, the 3.9. Back in July, there was a magnitude 3.5 in the same location. And what was interesting about the moment tensor ball, it showed spreading. Here's the 1.8. Now here we have pressure that moved both east and west. First wave of the earthquake. And tension going east. Here we have the magnitude 3.9. Looks like the fault moved going south, but the same thing, which is really odd. We got spreading. First wave of the earthquake straight up. Now tension here was applied going west. Same with the one in July, spreading. And this is a valley. This is an area, let me bring it out, which is not far from the Kern River Canyon Fault and Lake Isabella. Yeah, we know the danger of a large earthquake and the collapse of the dam there. This fault line is also a very dangerous fault line. It's a reverse fault with a left lateral slip movement. It begins in the south part of the valley near Lava Road exit on Interstate 5. The fault then trends 35 miles to the northeast, passing near Arvin. That's where I have the other earthquake monitor, on the south side of Bakersfield, California, before ending at the mouth of the Kern River Canyon. And this fault, as you can see, goes right underneath Lake Isabella. Some of the felt reports on EMSC, 5:30 a.m. in Bodfish, California. I felt a jolt and a rumble after the jolt. Sounded like a jet flying overhead. In a second flash, I woke my son up from sleeping. This one said they were awake, short rolling, mild impact at Lake Isabella. Lake Isabella house shook, good, but quick. Shook the roof, I thought it was wind at first. Scary. The whole house shook for a second. Let's see. Felt slight tremor, and then a loud, noisy jolt. Another one, quick jolt. Yeah, interesting. A reverse fault moves up and over the other side, and this is a left lateral moving fault. So the northern part of this fault zone is moving left, and the bottom part, the south, is moving right. And it's interesting that there's spreading going on with these earthquakes. Looking at the 3.9, you can see that kind of slightly the fault zone moves south and to the east, whereas the 1.8 actually shows more of a thrust earthquake. Tension mostly going east. Here you can see the tension was on the west, but the fault line is dipping towards the east. I come up with a magnitude 4.16, not a magnitude 3.9. Still, it's close, but it was larger than what they were saying. Once again, downgrading the size of the earthquake. And this was caused because of the tectonic plates moving, the fault lines moving one against the other, one rising up over the other. So did you feel this earthquake at 5:34 a.m. Pacific Standard Time? If so, please put your comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.